Hey guys, so today I want us to talk about, you know, measurements and rulers, specifically, you know, the ones I handed you guys out. So yeah, by now I've handed it out. You should have put your name on it on a sticker so you can identify it's yours. And I just want you guys to get comfortable with these, familiar with these. They're pretty simple to use. But it actually takes a while to get quick with them and understand, you know, what all the lines mean and memorize, you know, what each line is. So take a look at your ruler, and I want you guys to count how many lines are in the first inch, or any inch for that matter. And then I want you to look at those lines. So we'll look between 1 and 2 and see how many lines you can identify, how many different lines. And then, so once you've done that, you know, let's talk about those lines. So there's actually 16 increments in 1 inch. And we call those 16ths. And then you'll see those lines are all the lines. Each one represents a 16th. But you'll see other lines along the ruler have different lengths. So let me get something to point with. So what we're talking about is all these lines represent a 16th. And there's 16 of them in an inch. So there's 16 sixteenths in an inch. This is all just division. In the metric system, it's a lot simpler, and we'll talk about that in a little bit. But for now, we're just going to do the standard system that we use in America. Sorry, it's not focusing very well. So get familiar with all those lines, and you'll notice there's 16 increments in an inch and 16ths. So next step. So see all this line? See how that's a little longer than the first line? So those are eighths. And there's 8/8 in an inch. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Right? Does that make sense? Then the next line right there is even a little longer than the eighth line. See, here's our eighth line, and that one's a little longer, and then these 16th marks are the shortest, right? So we go 16th, eighth, there's another 16th. And then this line, that longer line, is a quarter. So there's 4/4 in an inch. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4. And so you can see those quarter lines are the most distinct lines. Then some rulers, this middle line, which is the half inch mark, you know, or halves, there's 2 halves in an inch. That line sometimes will be a little longer. But yeah, so that's the basics of your ruler on that side. We got 16ths, so 16/16 in an inch. We got 8ths, see those little guys? 8/8 in an inch, 4/4, and 2/2 in an inch, right? Then in some of our lessons, we'll be going even lower than that, and those measurements aren't on your ruler, but we'll be doing 32nds and 64ths, which are, you know, smaller. So you can think how many 32nds are in an inch, 32, how many 64ths are in an inch, 64. And a 32nd, there's 2 32nds in a 16th, and so on. So yeah, that's basically it. And so when you're learning to measure, you know, the best thing is to identify all those that we talked about: eighths, 16ths, quarters, halves, and then you can start at that the beginning of the inch, and you can just count. So like, say I said, let's measure 1.5 inch. So we go 1 inch, and then we know, you know, a 1/2 inch is going to be right in the center, so 1.5. But now what if I said 5/8? 1 inch, or excuse me, so what if I said 1 5/8? So for me, I know 1 5/8 is right over there, because 5/8 is 1/8 over a half, right? But if you're kind of confused by fractions, you know, that's okay. It's sometimes fractions can be confusing for many people. I know for me, they were, it took me a while to kind of understand those, to get quick at using a ruler. So, you know, a simple way to use it would be 1 5/8. So we go 1, and then we just count the eighths. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1 5/8, right? So what, 1 1/4. So we go 1, then we know that midline is a 1/4 inch line, so 1 1/4, right? 1 1/16, so 1, and then we count the first little line, which is a 1/16, 1 1/16. 1 3/16, 1, then 1 2 3/16. You always can just count them. It's not hard. What you can do is you can make a cheat sheet. You can draw this out and you can label all these, you know, eighths, quarters, sixteenths. You can label different measurements, and then that'll help you memorize it quickly so you can do it fast. Yeah, you know, measurements that people kind of get confused on are odds, like 1 3/8. So we go 1 inch and then 1 2 3/8. But again, it's all just simple arithmetic. It's simple counting. It's not hard to do. I know you guys can do it, and we'll do this in class more and get familiar with our rulers. So on the other side of your ruler, we got, you know, the metric system. We got millimeters and centimeters. I know this is gonna be upside down or whatever, but it doesn't really matter, backwards. So this is actually much more simpler, in my opinion and most people's opinion, than the other side. Basically, it's a very divisible system. It works in tens and hundreds and thousands. So 1 centimeter is 10 millimeters. So all of those little marks are representative of 1 millimeter, right? And then right in the middle, they have a little longer, so you can do 1 1/2 centimeters. Or traditionally that would be 1.5. So yeah, super simple. And I'm not going to make you memorize anything yet, but eventually we're going to want to memorize, you know, how many centimeters and millimeters are in an inch and all that. But thankfully, you guys all have smartphones. You can do all those calculations on your phone. But yeah, so that's basically it. So a little homework assignment, or I want you guys to research this or figure out this. I want you to tell me what's the easiest way to find center on a piece of paper. Using your ruler or not using your ruler? How can you find the center of a piece of paper without using your ruler or with using your ruler? And we'll talk about that in class, because finding center is kind of going to be one of those things in layout, fabrication, design, modeling, all that. Finding center is a real important thing to do, and there's many ways to do it, and we're going to talk about some of those in class. But for this assignment, I want you guys to start researching that and figure out a few ways to find center. All right, have a good rest of your day. Later.